Hey, what's going on, guys? Back again with another video here. Today I am bringing you the Deluxe Boon Boon Killer Robo that just released maybe about a week ago. Just got this in the mail today from Tokyo Collectibles. Pretty good website. Been using a lot to get all the Boon Boon cars and all the mecha so far. Pretty good, guys. Pretty decent shipping to get it here from Japan in a timely manner. Had a few moments to play with this thing. It's pretty freaking dope. I do like this mecha. I've been waiting for this thing to get released for quite some time. Had it pre-ordered all the way back in August when the pre-orders went up, and it's finally here in the States. Like I said, it is pretty cool looking. I like the design, the little Mad Max look. It is pretty sweet in the anime as well. So let's dig in and see what this guy is all about. First on the cover here, you can see the, excuse my pronunciation, the Hashirana. Pretty cool, guys. I do like the comedic relief of these villains here. They are pretty cool. I do like this little car. I wish I was able to get the plushie that came out with this, but I believe it has been sold out. If they do release it or find a secondhand, I will be definitely grabbing this guy. So yeah, it is the full Robo set. So you do get the Boon Killer Robo as well with the changer, and then you get the two cars, which I'll show you on the side. There's a little bit more of the labeling there. Boon Boon Killer Robo and Boon Boon Danger. Here's the backside, and he looks pretty freaking cool. Zoom in just a smidge here. So yeah, here are the two cars that he comes with. There are just slight remolds of Pink and Blue's car, and then a slight remold of the Boondario mold for the Boondanger Mecha. Nice cool chest piece that it comes with. Nice flame, I wouldn't say flame, but kind of like a rotten, degrading, rusting look throughout the robot. We'll take a look at the head sculpt. The head sculpt's pretty sweet looking. So yes, on this side, more of the same. Nothing on top, just says Boon Boon Killer Robo. Just your typical warning. And let's get this box out of the way. This is a premium banner release, so it did come in a really cool outer box. I will be putting back in there just to keep this nice and safe. This is one of my first premium things that I've gotten from any Sentai. So this was more costly than just your normal Boon Boon Drew Robo set. I believe I paid around $1.20 to get it shipped here. Still not bad. I've seen them go up higher now that it's been released. If you're able to find a good used one without the box, definitely pick it up. It is a cool little Robo. So yeah, give me 1 second. Let me get the cars set out here. So there he is. This is everything you get in the box. You get the changer, the two cars, and the Boon Killer Robo himself. Pretty good set. I do like these cars. I do like that it gives you the changer. I do know that this will be getting a normal retail release, if not already. The only difference is it won't come with the changer. It only comes with the premium Bandai release. You only get this through that. So that's the only thing I know that will be different from the normal retail release when it comes out, or if it's out by the time this video goes up. But still, nonetheless, still a cool Robo to get. I definitely now need to get the changer, the regular one from the Boon Boonger set, to go with this to show off the comparisons. But I am liking this. It is pretty cool. We'll play some sounds from this in a few moments. So yeah, let's take a good look at these cars and the Robo and then the changer and compare to the OG Boondario and Pink and Blue cars. So let's take a look at this car here. It is, like I said, a slight remold of the Blue Ranger's car. This forms a Phillips screwdriver, I believe, in the Blue Ranger car. This one is just a drill. We'll show it here in a few moments. Nice deco. Same with that nice rustic, cybernetic, whatever you want to call it, look on it. Pretty cool looking. Here is the Blue Ranger's car to compare it to. Again, like I said, it's a slight remold, but overall the same car. Kind of has the same functions. different number on the bottom. The blue one, hard to say. It's B011. This one's B050. They do make different noises in the changer. I believe on the normal one, not so much on the danger changer. Sorry. but yeah, overall, cool little car. So that's that one. And then for the Pink Rangers one, this one forms a glove. And it is the same thing in this one, just a little more Mad Maxi. You got the nice sculpted detail on the hood. The same degraded look on the windshield. But overall, a nice, cool looking car. Here is the pink one to compare it to. Take a slight mold, remold on the front. This is a little more raised, kind of more of a construction look. But overall, the same basic design. It does the same function as this pink one does. For pink, it is B012, and this one is B050. All right, and then let's take a look at the main Robo Killer himself. Bring this down just a smidget. So, love this guy. This thing is pretty sweet looking. I do like the Tampograph designs on this, the browns, the blacks, the orange. It works so well. Then we get to the front. This is a whole new piece. This is actually detachable. You can put it on the normal Boom Boom Drew Mecha to give it a nice kind of cool look. But still, it is a cool molding piece right here. But everything else is roughly the same as the normal Boom Boom Drew Robo. Get some nice skulls down here in the feet. You'll see that more once we get to the robot mode. Wheels have nice curved spikes on that. Overall, like I said, it's pretty cool. So let me get Lundario out here to compare. And here he is here. Like I said, there they are, the same size, except a little bit of length for the front grill there. But overall, pretty cool robos themselves. So like I said, swing this guy around. This is detachable and it comes detached in the packaging. Just held down by a little bit of friction. And that's that. And then you get to that front end versus Bundario's front end. It's the same mold. You got the same truck lights there. Nothing really changed on here. So it kind of looks bland if you don't have this thing on. But this guy you can also put on here. Upside down. You kind of give him a little bit more of a menacing look. And that's pretty much it. It just snaps on in place. Pretty cool. I don't know if they're going to do an add-on down in the future for just to have this guy, this mask on this guy, or if in the show he's going to get it, but it's a cool little plaything. So put him off to the side, put this mask back on him, and we'll take a look at the changer here. Yeah, this just snaps on somehow. I just had it. That's the fight now. There it goes. Pack on it. So let's take a look at this changer. Pretty cool, just like the normal Boom Boom changer. Got the roller here, got the switch, LED light on top, and this is your on and off switch right here. So cool, you're able to turn it on and off. Sometimes they don't give you that option and it stays on for a while. So let's kick this guy on. Cool little guitar solo there. Pretty cool overall. So we can put the cars on here. We'll get some, I think, some additional sound effects. Oh, that didn't do anything. Let's try it again. Oh, maybe I turned it off. Hold on. There we go. I must have accidentally turned it off. There we go. I like that guitar riff right there. So nothing really to do with the car, just a bunch of phrases they say. Let's put the other one on. I do like this riff. A little remix there. That's a new one. But yeah, pretty cool. Turn this guy off here. But yeah, I do like the changer. It is pretty sweet. It doesn't come with the arm clip. I believe you can get that separately from the normal Boom Boom changer if you get that. Or I believe Tokyo Collectibles may still have the armband that you can purchase. I'm not too sure. Just check it out. I'm pretty sure you can find an armband that fits this guy. But yeah, this thing is pretty sweet looking. And let's get to the main guy himself and get him transformed and put him together with the normal Boondario Robo. So same transformation as that guy there. What you want to do is bring this out. You can put him in gate mode just like the regular mecha. Pop his hood, and then you can transform the other cars into their weapon mode. Same thing, just clip it on and then just push it forward. Oop, and then crush it. Restart. Oop, or just throw it out. Right, that's a first. All right. There we go. It just came undone a little bit. One, two, three. There we go. So yeah, he comes out as like a drill bit, rusty drill bit. Pretty cool looking. A little bit of browns on the inside. Nice detail there. Let's reset this for the other car. And without dropping everything, as I do. Oh, I did it again. There we go. Comes out, and again, you got the glove. Just bring this down and around. And a little bit more detail. The thumb, you get a little gray on the inside. Nothing too crazy there. So those are all the cars that come with it. There is a special car that came with the movie, summer movie or something like that. It kind of goes with this set. Has the same kind of basic rust look, orange windshield. This is the black police car mold that's come out already. Except this one doesn't have a helmet. This one becomes a helmet. This is just the Hashirama's driving the car. I'll show you here. Bring this back. And there we go. It pops out just like the police car does. And then there they are inside the cockpit, just driving it. And then this is where normally the helmet would be. Just pop that up. And it's the little pal they drive around with. So yeah, he's pretty cool. You can also have it like this, so you can drive with him on top. And then you can put this up, and if it was normal helmet mode, it would be like this. But obviously he's not a helmet, so that's the way it is for this car. Nothing really you can do for the robo. I mean, I guess you have it like for armor for the arm, or like a little battering ram. That's about, I would say, you can use this guy for. Put him off to the side. So let's continue on with the robo here. Bring you guys up and bring you guys a little further out here. So picking this guy up about the same way. Arms go back, both sides. I like to turn this around until you get to this here. Same thing for the other side. Bring that around so you get that there. Swing it down, let it click. Stretch his feet out. You can stretch the little cape out. bring this around. Oop. And likes to pop off. Okay. Pop this back on. There we go. There we go. All right. And then we bring the head down. This goes back just like the other robot. And bam. There we have Boom Boom Killer Robo. Nice robot form here. I do love the head sculpt. Let's take a look at that right now. Really evil look to this robo. I love that. Kind of a molten look inside his face. Zoom in on there. Focus on that. Pretty cool. Like an evil grin that it has. And then now let's attach the other guys. So we get this one on this arm, fold that down, and then this guy here just pegs on to the side. And bam, there you go. You got him all weaponized and ready to destroy the Boom Boonger Robo itself. And I do say I like this. It all comes together very, very well. Little skulls on his feet, that face sculpt. The chest armor piece, just the colors, everything works really well with this guy. I do enjoy it. Pretty cool, pretty cool. He is compatible with every other thing that the normal robo was able to connect to. The 119 Rescue, the other cars, Boom Diesel. You can pretty much combine any transformation that they've had in the show to this guy here. I don't have the Champion liner yet. It is on its way. I don't know what's going on with that, but this made it before that, and the other one came out a month ago. So that one's still on its way. When it gets here, I'll make a review. We'll put it together with this guy here to check it out and see what it looks like. But let me get the other robo put together so you can compare how these guys look standing next to each other. And there you have them next to each other. And man, these things look pretty freaking cool on there. So yeah, you can see how they compare to each other, fully transformed. I say these are a pretty good mecha. I do like the way these guys kind of interact with each other in the show. The show's on its final legs, basically, nearing the end. Only a couple more episodes left, and I can't wait to see what happens. And if we get anything special down the line, I think we're done with the mecha. Maybe a special car here and there, but otherwise, if it ends after Boom Boom Killer Robo, then so be it. But yeah, this thing is freaking sweet. I highly, highly recommend grabbing this guy if you're able to. Especially if you're a big fan of the show. Gotta complete it. Pretty cool. Let me throw the other car on the other arm so you kind of can see how it can look if you're just using this like a battering arm kind of thing. We'll just remove this guy here and have this guy on this arm. So yeah, looks like a little punching fist here. Pretty cool, but not bad. So yeah, pretty good robo. Do recommend picking it up. We'll check out another video. We'll have them combined with the Boom Diesel and the 119 Leo Rescue, just to check out that transformation and see how he looks. But yeah, I am enjoying this guy for what he is. Freaking sweet, big robot, cool Mad Max vibes. But yeah, I will see you guys another time. And enjoy yourselves and be safe. I'll turn this guy back on. But definitely worth it. Big explosions everywhere. But guys, all right, you guys have a good night. Please like and subscribe. Hit us up on here, give us a comment, and let us know your favorite car, robo, or whatever Sentai, or even Power Rangers show, if you guys enjoy. So we'll catch you on the flip side. Take care and have a good night.